Remember the house first. Get loot. Get loot.
Yeah, I lost like four villagers in the first session.
No, get loot first. You're playing his mines.
Yeah.
I did get loot. Hey everybody, welcome back to another coaching session. Today we're gonna switch it up. I'm with Black T. We're playing a Mayans War. His opponent this game will be Simply Be Yourselves. Also playing as the Mayans. When you play as the Mayans, get loom first. You need to watch my strategy guide video. You get loom first as the Mayans. And then you. Alright, build the villager, build the villager. Now you've already found your sheep.
I did.
Yeah, you already found it.
Then.
Now, when you build the house, let's see. When you build the house, you're able to, after you're done building it, send one of the villagers out to scout. It's not so vital you get all that wood in. It's more important you find your sheep early. Scout with a few of your
Yeah.
sheep. Make sure to use your control groups. Alright. Hurry it up, hurry it up. We're losing food. Next villager goes to wood. We can't fit any more villagers on that sheep. Alright, so we're playing against Mayans. I'll ask him about a strategy in just a second. I want to make sure his dark gauge stabilizes. Alright, keep building the villagers, keep building the villagers.
Yeah, I hit the fourth drop.
And let's get that lumber line up. Try to time this perfectly. Bring your sheep in a little bit. It's too far away from the town center. Good. Keep the town center rolling. This is the third time it's been idle. And make sure the lumber camp is always touching the wood.
Oh, yeah.
Good. Try no idle time this time. No idle time. Alright, better. So, what is our strategy this game? Keep the eagle moving, keep the town center working. What are you thinking of as far as an opening
Let me
strategy?
think. Drash archers, I guess.
Okay, that's perfectly viable. Do you think your map is good enough for fast castle archers?
I don't know, I have forward gold.
Well, that's your side gold. Watch your board.
Oh, yeah.
Do you think you could fully wall your map?
Oh, I think so, yeah.
I don't think you can. I think the top side looks like that's going to be a huge wall. Keep your town center working, it's still idle. And with the villager on the berries, you could build a house and then a mill. So I think this map is too big to wall. Like, if you look at the top, it's going to be way too large. So I think a Dark Age rush into arches is the best option.
Yeah, okay.
Now, if your mind, so you like to go for a fast castle arches if you can, but I don't think our map is that good. And bring your three sheep in, just in case he wants to steal those. Keep the town center building. And let's place the next few villagers on that boar because that boar is still rotting. Let's get another house up and then the barracks. You can use one of the lumberjacks. Alright, the barracks is gonna be a little late.
Oh, did I found all my sheep? Find all my sheep?
Yes, you did. You killed an extra one.
Okay.
Good, let's get that barracks up. Keep the town center rolling. This is the fifth time it's been idle. Your opponent is on 20 population. 21 now.
Okay.
Just from idle time. Boyd's barracks is up super late. Now, how is your barracks up at the correct time, or do you think it's late?
I think it's late.
It's late, yeah. So let's go for men-at-arms instead. This is not the preferred strategy, but you already have enough food to click up. So let's take that sheep. And I lied, you're missing two sheep. I'm sorry. Keep the town center working, though. Good. Let's seed up two farms. Seed two farms. No, keep getting food. We need the food. So use your stragglers to take food. And you can click up now. Use the straggler tree villagers, the ones that are taking that palm forest tree, to take sheep instead.
Okay.
And start building militias. You can build a mining camp on your gold. For men-at-arms, you'll need two villagers on gold. And with your scout, make sure you're always scouting his base. And also, the mining camp should be towards your town center. That way, those villagers will be much safer.
Okay, I guess it's too late to change it now.
Yeah, keep building militias. Good, and I think that's enough farms. We need a second villager on gold, though. Good, build another militia. His drush is coming in. Let's bring our eagle back. Our eagle needs to be at our base. Watch his militia. Can you quick wall your woodline? But you want to use palisade walls. The palisade walls are going to be cheaper. Good. Quick wall your gold. Bring your militia out. Bring your eagle. Good. Get all of your villagers back working. And bring your militia out. When you got the 40 gold, upgrade to men-at-arms. You can get your wood upgrade now. And finish up that sheep. We're running low on food. So finish up that sheep with those wood villagers. Good. Force drop the villager and get the men-at-arms upgrade. Good. Go engage his army. Watch your villagers on the berries. You're going to want to fight that if it's three villagers versus two militia. Good. Put those villagers back on berries. And we need a house. Good. Good defense. Make sure you check out your idols. Your woodline is completely idle. Do you have your wood upgrade?
Oh, yes.
You still have an idol on your wood line. Alright, we have too much food at the moment. Good, move out with your men-at-arms and eagle and go hit his gold. He's got to be taking his gold, right?
Yeah.
No more farms, we need the archery range. You have to check your food count at this point, we have too much food. Delete the farm. Ah, that's a big mistake. Send those villagers out to take wood. Let's just add a few eagle warriors. Because we need to build something. So the biggest problem here is the transition. The transition to the archer ranges is extremely delayed. Let's see if we can do damage with this men-at-arms. The men-at-arms defense was perfect. The transition is what's messed up. Alright, watch his drush. Good. Make sure you watch your militias. Maybe stand ground stance. It depends on how much you want to watch those guys. Let's get two archery ranges up at the same time. Good. And let's get the farm upgrade.
Okay.
Do you think you're gonna find anything over there with your men at arms?
I'm looking for a woodline.
Well, you already found his first woodline.
Yeah, okay.
I would have just stayed at his gold. That would have forced him to make skirmishers. Good. Let's get a blacksmith up too. And another house. And get town watch. And you could right-click your army inside his base, and you'll probably find a hole.
Yeah, I did that.
Attack the weak villager. And you can start making archers. I would even get a third archery range, because we have too much wood and gold. That'll help to spend the wood and gold. Keep harassing with your men-at-arms. Let's get a third archery range up. We need to spend our wood and gold. And let's take maybe six wood choppers off and build six farms. Now those men-at-arms can do some damage. I would engage the villagers.
But he's idling them a lot because of.
Yeah, but this isn't militia. These are men-at-arms. These guys can actually kill villagers. It'd be better if we could kill villagers. Also, bring your archers in. Let's build five more farms with five more lumberjacks. Just go in with your men-at-arms. They can kill villagers. He's been able to get up to a fast castle, and we still haven't killed a villager. Well, we killed one, but we could have killed more.
Yeah.
So, if you have men-at-arms are deadly. You can kill villagers with those. Let's get that third archery range up. Bring your archers in.
Oh, I wasn't watching my army.
Let's click up to the next age. And you can get fletching. Let's build five more farms with five more lumberjacks. Okay, we've got plus one armor, damn. So the fact that he's able to make eagles is because we haven't kept him off his gold. Or this gold, too. The men-at-arms should have been patrolling here rather than walking all the way around. Attacking the market. They just stayed in this area. We would have prevented our opponent from making these eagles by preventing him from taking gold. Let's click up to the next age.
Yeah, okay. I'm lacking 53.
Now, where is he getting that gold?
Probably under the tower.
Yeah, probably. Do you see a weakness in his base?
It's either the main gold.
And where is he taking wood?
Over there, I guess.
No, you had your archers there.
But it's also next to the gold, probably.
Okay, so he's got his wood and he's got his gold all in the same place. Do you think that that could probably be a weak spot in this map, right?
Yeah, I guess we could go for some kind of siege.
Yeah, I would go for a siege workshop in that area. And there's a hill there, too. You got problems at your base, though. Try to quick wall as much as you can up. Bring some archers back to defend. You have archers from those three ranges. Keep making archers from those three ranges. Wall up everything that you possibly can. And don't see that farm. We need the farm for a market now because gold's going to be a problem. You have to look at your resources and say you have 500 food. You probably don't need another farm.
Yeah, okay.
Watch your army. Watch your army.
Oh.
Yeah, watch your army in the bottom. Bring your army on the bottom back to your base. And watch your archers in your base now. Simply as eco is not that much better yet. Just because you have a second town center doesn't mean your eco is better. Okay, we need a market. Let's get a market up so we can afford all of our good upgrades. Gonna lose these two archers. Right, let's get that market up. I don't know if that market's gonna get up.
Shot it. God damn.
Yeah, build another market somewhere else. Let's get the wood upgrade. Take five of your farmers off and put them onto gold. Take the other five and put them onto wood. So take 10 farmers off. There you go. You can sell 300 food. Oh, Jesus. But sell 500 food. But keep building arches. Get crossbow, bodkin arrow. You can sell more food if you need to. Bring your army that's in his base back to your base. Ah, Jesus. You're still making arches, but I don't see crossbow coming up. Oh, Jesus.
Oh, okay.
Seen this? No. We need to get crossbow. And bodkin arrow. And let's get a town center on this gold.
Oh, should I put it in the middle?
Town center on gold.
Yeah, okay.
Wood upgrade. Do you have the wood upgrade?
Yeah, I do.
Keep building archers, take five of your farmers off and put them on your wood line. You have too many farmers. There we go, better. Good, group your archers together, here comes a raid. We need to keep making archers. Alright, we need a siege workshop for the Megano. Let's get a siege workshop up. Use your market. The town center, man! Jesus. Good, let's get a mangonel up. Keep making the arches. Do we have any stone? Where's the stones? Stones here. Take your crossbows out of your town center. Alright, well, we can't do damage. These eagles are gonna get us. I don't know how we won this game. Yeah, I don't know how we win this game. Hope we get like with the Meganos. There you go, simply be yourselves, he's learned something. Go for the Meganos, go for the Meganos! There you go. Gonna get that Megan. Perfect, perfect. Perfect from our opponent. Alright, I think it's a good time to call GG.
Yeah, probably.
Alright, where do you think it went wrong?
Probably my build order, and the fact that he was able to get up to the castle age much quicker than I did.
I don't think it was your build order so much. I think your build order was fine. Where do you think, when you came in with the men-at-arms, do you think you made a good men-at-arms rush?
No, I mean, I forced him out of his goal, but I didn't kill any villagers. Like, maybe I killed one, but I didn't do any good damage to him.
Well, forced him off of his gold for about a minute, and then he went back to the gold once you left the gold. So you went to the gold, right? Then you went around to the right side, and then you went to the back of his base, and then you went to his market, and then you went to the left where the walls were, and then you came back through the hole, and then after that you started attacking the villagers, but then you went back to the market, and then you came back in through his base once he was in Castle Age, right?
Yeah.
What would have happened if you left your men-at-arms just at his golds?
I probably would have slowed him down too much.
Well, it takes 200 gold to go to the next age, right?
Yeah.
So
he would need to sell the resources, probably, or...
And he wouldn't have eagles. Remember, he went into eagles, and...
Yeah.
Remember, he had, like, two or three eagles by the time you went in and he was in Castle Age. So the best choice for the men-at-arms is just to keep them at the golds and not to move them anywhere. Not to have them go around the back. That was the first mistake, I feel. The second mistake was we were too late to get into the archer transition. We seeded too many farms to start out with. I think we had 5 farms. We should have had probably 3 farms.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
If you saved 120 wood, it would have allowed you to get 2 ranges up much sooner. And then I would have put more villagers onto the first lumber camp. That way you didn't have to spend the 100 wood on the second lumber camp in the back. So then we could have got the archers out faster. Once you get the archers out, you have to send them over to attack his base. They were standing around attacking the market for some time as well.
Yeah, I had the gather point there.
Yeah, so you have to make sure they're moving in into his wood line and moving in to attack his golds, because he was struggling a lot as soon as he got it to the castle age, because he couldn't really make anything and his economy was pretty bad. And after that, he was going to eagles. It's hard to go crossbows against eagles if we're already behind. And, yeah. How do you think that game went for yourself, Simply Be Yourselves?
I think that he hurt me a lot and in the feudal age. And I think that if he was able to either do more pressure or get to the castle age sooner, then I would have been dead. I think that my economy, I couldn't really make any eagles as soon as I hit the castle age, but because I had a second town center, by the time he got to the castle age, my economy had caught up a bit, and I'd upgraded to eagle warriors from eagle scouts. And I think that once I got the mangonels out with against the crossbows, I think it's because my economy was able to catch up, I think, that I was able to I think I did okay considering I think the second town center was a good idea. Because if I tried to pressure without that, I think that I wouldn't have had the economy to actually make anything, you know. I think that allowed me to replace the damage that was done to me. Because I got to the castle age sooner, I was really, and he damaged me a lot, I was really weak economy, but because I had the tag in town center and he got to the castle age a lot later than me, I was able to catch up economically, and I think that's why I managed to win.
I would disagree a little bit. I actually don't think it was the second town center that allowed you to go push. I think the decision to go to Eagle Warriors was the decision. I think you could have done that off of one town center as well, but Eagle Warriors are just so strong against crossbows. I really like that decision.
Yeah.
One thing about your map. Does your map? Do you think your map is
Yeah,
better
I just.
for a archer rush like in Feudal Age, or better for a fast castle?
Let me think. I've got a really close. I've got. My main goal is.
Well, did you wall your base? Your base
I
is not
tried
fully
to.
walled. If you go for a fast castle, you have to fully wall your base.
Yeah,
Because
I
just
did.
walling here and there doesn't stop, you know, men-at-arms from coming in or archers from coming in.
Yeah.
So I think your base would have been better, at least with the way you walled it this game. It'd probably been better to go for a Dark Age rush into archers. And if you think about
Yeah.
it, you'd say you did that much earlier, right? You could have attacked Argold early on anyway. If you went for the
Yeah.
archer rush, you ended up
I
coming
think
back anyway with Siege Workshop, but you could have attacked it earlier with the archers.
That I'm not practiced with Dark Age. I think my Dark Age rush was so slow, and I was so. I decided to go Castle Age because I got late to feud, so late to feudal without really doing any damage with my militia. So
Okay.
that's why I decided. I thought that I'll put that I put thought I'd put a tower on my gold, and I realized if I just walled up more fully, I wouldn't need to do that. And then I had to sell when he attacked my other gold, I had to then sell resources to. Yeah, I see what you mean about I probably could have done that from one town center, but I think that by the time he reached the Castle Age, I'd already got the second town center and was replacing the damage he'd done to me. I wonder if I'd be able to really produce anything if I hadn't got the second town center. Maybe I would have, and maybe I'm
I don't think the
underestimating.
economy advantage of your town center has kicked in yet. It's only been up for about
No.
5 minutes, 6 minutes. It takes a little bit
Well,
longer for the economy advantage to kick in. I think
because
if
I
you went
was.
one
Yeah.
town center, you would have been able to get the Eagle Warrior upgrades a lot easier and go forward a bit sooner.
Yeah.
And
I
I
guess
think
I
that would
didn't
have been
think about that.
preferred because just because the unit you're going into, you want to go more
Yeah.
aggressive, and also because his gold is exposed and you have that hill there. So I think it would have been better to get the army out even sooner. And then you can
Oh,
add the
right,
town
so
center in later.
I didn't think about the fact it takes a while to kick in. Like, I was just thinking that if I produce twice as much villains as I can replace the damage that's been done to me, but I guess that probably actually delayed my army, didn't it?
Yeah, well, you did
Yeah.
fine. I mean, you did well in the end. I really liked the. I think the Siege Workshop could be even closer with what kind of army control you have. And
Yeah,
I
I
like you
just
had
wanted to
enough
get them out really
mangonels.
quickly, yeah.
You almost botched the army control, but you got it perfect. You sent the eagles in to take out the mangonel. When you do that, I would only send three at a time because if he has a ton of crossbows in behind that and he garrisons the town centers, can really take out a lot of your own eagles. So I would only send as many as you
Yeah.
need. Three should be a
I
safe
made a
number.
mistake running the I made a mistake running so many eels into his crossbow because I could have held them back and fired the, if I really I was trying to hold them back and fire the mangonels at the town center and the crossbows, and I was trying to redirect them away, but I ended up, you know, trying to take out his mangonels, but then I ran in front of the town center and fought the town center. I didn't mean to do that, but then in the end I realized I looked like I had enough eagles and mangonels anyway,
Yeah,
so.
it worked out in the end, and you're still producing eagles anyway, so that worked out. I would have just yeah,
Yeah.
sniped the mangonel and then just came back.
Yeah, I sent in too many. Sometimes it's a case of because I can't be quick enough, I just do it, and it's easier to select a huge group quicker than to pick out three. You know what I mean? So sometimes when
Yeah, I
I'm trying to be
understand.
fast and I'm doing many things at once.
Do you think your Dark Age
clumsy deliberately just because it's quicker?
Do you think your Dark Age Rush did no damage?
It did a tiny, tiny bit of damage.
It did a bit. I mean,
because I did manage to get his.
What I wanted to say is that
but it was so late.
Yeah, but the Dark Age Rush did two things. I mean, maybe it did three things for you, right? The two things that were big is that you didn't see, but just by him getting those walls up, his villagers idled, and he forgot to retask his villagers. You know, as players get better and better, they remember more and more to retask their villagers, but, you know, we still forget every now and then.
Also, it did more damage than I realized, yeah.
Yeah, and second thing is that you kept him busy. He was going to go for men-at-arms, and you kept his men-at-arms in his own base for an additional 2 minutes. That could have given you more time to wall or time to get out your archers to counter the men-at-arms. If you went for the Dark Age Rush, he goes for the men-at-arms. His men-at-arms cleans up your Dark Age Rush, and then his men-at-arms come to your base. If you already have archers out, that's a win for you because you've invested less resources.
Yeah, that's true, because the men-at-arms upgrade, it uses more food than archers and that.
Yeah, so just by keeping him busy, that's a win. Even if he didn't kill anything.
I feel like, if he wasn't defending my Drush, then even though it was super late, because he kept his men-at-arms back, like, I feel like if he'd come out and attacked, if I hadn't done that, he would have attacked me sooner. And I probably wouldn't have even been able to get to Castle Age, or I'd get there with no resources, you know?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And for you, the last thing is for your first lumber camp, make sure your lumber camp's closer to your town center. That one's kind of exposed.
Yeah, yeah. Some of these things, it's just a case of trying to play quickly. I do the wrong thing, you know.
Do you have any other questions, Black Team?
I just do it.
Yeah, I mean, as my main problem, I see that I didn't really manage my economy well. I had too much food at pretty much all points of the game. And as Mayans, I probably would use more gold and wood.
Yeah, I think wood was archers. The big one. Wood was the big one we were missing.
The first thing that I see is that probably, you know, I should have gone for the lumber camp at the back of my base instead for the one, like for the lumber line.
I think your lumber lines are fine. I don't think it would have been better or worse if they were both in the back. Because the saturation on the front one looks pretty good. And we did wall it up when that Drush came in. I think the big thing is we should have done a lot more damage with the early aggression that we had. And then not allowed him to go, you know, to push us back.
It really messed up my economy. It's only because I got to Castle Age a lot sooner that I was able to win, I think. You know, if I got to Castle Age the time he did, I would have been dead. Yeah.
All right. Would you guys like to play one more game? Or two?